Hi everyone, welcome back to the Learn Scriptcase from Scratch course. We're on part four still, continuing part four, looking at applications, specifically blank applications this time around. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So as you can see, here's where we are in the course outline, looking at applications still. So let's look at how we're going to use blank applications. As you know, we've been using Global Music Supply as a case study, a fictional company, and we've just built a lot of sales applications and we have one more to go. So we built some applications for the salespeople to enter their sales to update the quantity on hand. Then we built a tab application so that all the three of those applications can be linked together in one application. They can just switch between tabs instead of having to load them all. But they're still not the most technical people, the salespeople. So we want to make sure that we can help them any way we can. So we're going to write up some instructions and format them nicely. So maybe you know a little HTML, and so you can make them look nice. So we're going to use a tab application. We can just drop in any code, PHP, JavaScript, HTML, etc., to make it do and look anything like we want. So let's go ahead and do this. It's very simple, and I have some HTML written up to help us with this. So let's go over to Scriptcase and get started with blank applications. Okay, so we're back in our sales folder in the Scriptcase development environment, and we've got our sales applications here, and now we're going to create a new application. So go up to New Application, and this is going to be a blank application. So blank applications are very simple, very straightforward, and if you know a little bit of code, they can be very useful. If you're not much of a coder, you don't need to worry about these. But if you do start doing more with code, you're going to want to use the blank application. So choose a blank application and input the name. So I'm going to call this sales intro, like so, and go ahead and click create on that. Wait for that to come around and load. And then we should just about be ready to go. So the first area that you're going to see is the on execute area. So that's the main area, the main thing you really need to worry about. You can, if you're going to execute some database queries of any sort, you can set the default SQL connection by going to SQL and changing that connection. You also have some layout settings, but very simple. There's not a lot here since there isn't a lot already set up by Scriptcase. A lot of this is coming from your own code. So this on execute section is where we can put anything we want. So I've got some code copied here. The first bit is PHP, and I'm using the make link to get a link to our input sales applications. So we're going to use that in our HTML later down in the code here. And then what we're doing is we're opening up, or we're closing actually, our PHP section so we can put some HTML, and then we're opening it back up at the end so it can continue processing. We have some styling here, so a little bit of CSS. And then we have a big div sales intro that is linked to our styling there. That'll make it look a little bit nicer. Then we have some H1s, and then we have some ordered list with instructions for each type of sales input. So record, instrument, and sheet music. And then we're putting a link right down at the bottom with that link that we got up here with that make link macro. So that's just a variable that we're echoing out from the PHP. So make sure that's all formatted correctly. And then we can go ahead and run this and it should work. So really, once you have the code set up, you can pretty much drop it inside of your blank application and you'll be ready to go. So as you can see, here are our instructions. They look nice and they should help our sales users input their sales. If we click next, then we can link it then and go through to our input sales application that we created in the last video. And then we can click the back button to go back to those. So if they're not sure of the instructions, they can go back and read them again. So that'll be helpful for our sales users. So that's how you create blank applications to do pretty much whatever you want inside of Scriptcase.